Did you know that she has to use this cup during this period and then reuse it in the next?
That's what. Did you know that's the whole point, Srishti?
Just give me a penis.
I started getting my period, I think, in around the 8th grade.
And I remember being really excited for it.
I was late compared to some other girls in my class and I was very self-conscious about it.
And I still get excited every time I get my period naturally because I have PCOD and it's really exciting to know that I'm at least on the track of being healthier.
I actually, blessedly, have a very chill period.
My standard cycle is actually 7 days, but 4 of the days are intense.
No cramps, only 3 days, light bleeding.
I don't get cramps, but I do have a very heavy flow.
Typically, I've used pads. That's just what's introduced to us. I think when everyone gets their period, they are given a pad and taught how to use one. Especially in India, where people are squeamish about virginity. Early 20s, I started using tampons.
I've never really used anything apart from pads and tampons.
I haven't tried cloth pads, reusable chaddi things, cups, nothing.
But now I can't help but think about how many pads I must have used in the 12 years, because I do realize that I'm pretty fortunate to be able to afford these products, and I really wanted to see how it would be to make this healthy switch to something that's not only pocket friendly but also environment friendly.
I wanted to try menstrual cups for a very, very long time.
So for my next cycle, I will be switching on to cloth pads.
So I bought my cups from an Indian company called Boond Cup.
So it arrived from the internet, and then I had this tiny cup in my hand, which was much smaller than I imagined. So, you know, having been daunted by the prospect of putting like a giant cup, it wasn't. It's a small cup.
So the first thing I did was go online and search for cloth pads. They came in so many different patterns and colors, and yeah, I'm genuinely quite excited to just, well, bleed all over them.
Hi, I'm Rega's menstrual cup. I'm about to be inside her vagina.
Once there's a cup in my hand and there's blood coming out of me, how to pair these two occurrences with one another. Did a lot of research and then I just got to it.
So I'm reading the instructions. The first thing I'm supposed to do is boil it in water.
A lot of people had said online, you know, it's best if you practice before your period starts. I was like, it all. I'm brave, I'm ready. And you know, just did a little squat in a private part of my home and just became really good friends with my vagina.
Oh my god, it's so far inside. Oh my god, is it open? I can't tell if it's open and I can't tell if it will ever come out again.
It wasn't difficult to figure out how the cloth pads worked if you used a disposable pad. The only difference was in the mechanics of it. Here, the wings had a little clip on it so you could secure your pad onto your underwear. I was pretty confident I know how to work this.
I was f***ing shocked. It was so easy.
I think I did it right. When I tried to pull it out, it was frozen there by suction, which is supposed to happen, and which made it really hard to pull out. So I'm a little nervous that this cup will be inside of me forever now, or that this video will end with like me in a hospital and a doctor like slicing my vagina open to get this cup out.
My initial reaction after wearing the cloth pad, I was pleasantly surprised. I just wore the pad. It feels great. I thought it's gonna be a little bulky, like I'm wearing a diaper, but no, it feels pretty normal. I was just very excited for the fact that now my vagina is gonna be able to breathe through all the cloth. I was like, yes, I need this. I've been waiting for this. But I was wrong.
You think at this point it's sort of like secure? Yeah, but honestly, it's not because it slides down.
I was gonna bleed for the next 7 days and I had to use these cloth pads that were not staying where they were supposed to stay.
I'm really trying hard to like this product, but it's not working out.
I'm on my way to work, my cup is in. I'm not wearing a pad or anything else as backup. I'm trusting the cup. And you know what? I feel really, really good about it.
All through that first day, every time I went to go pee, I expected like at least a spot, like one hint that blood is coming out of me.
So it's been 12 hours. I'm about to change it and still no leak. Clean chaddis, clean white chaddis during my period. It's magic. I'm Harry Potter. Wizardry is in my chaddis right now, guys.
Through the day, there was nothing. It like worked extremely effectively. It was quite painless.
Every time I went to pee, I would pull them down and I would notice that the pad would just rotate. Like it was angry at me and it didn't want to look at my face. So it would just like look the other way. And that just didn't make any sense.
Waking up in the morning, knowing you have your period, putting this thing in, and then cancelling your period for 12 hours. You just don't have to deal with it again till the end of the day when you have to take the thing out. Unlike pads and tampons, where every time you go pee, you're like, oh yeah, I'm bleeding also.
So on my second day of period, I decided to wear a white dress. And we were working not from our office, but from an outside space where there would be other people around. And my only aim for that day was that I do not want to leak. I don't want to ruin my white dress.
And I'm going to make Deeksha my period stain buddy. So basically, she's gonna tell me if I stain my beautiful white dress.
Just because the TV ad told you that periods ke din mein white pehen sakte hain, you wore white with a cloth pad.
At the end of the day, I do remember sitting there at one space.
So I've been sitting in the same spot for like almost 3 hours now.
I could still feel it move every time I'd get up, which was still an annoying factor. And to add on top of this inconvenience was the fact that you need to wash them.
So I scrubbed it pretty hard and there's still a stain on it. And you can see that the fabric is coming out.
Because the rest of the experience was so bad, the idea of washing them was making me even more irritated.
I'm still just mind blown by how effective this experience is.
So all the advice was about how the cup is going to be really high inside and it'll be hard to reach it. So what I'm supposed to do is empty this out and then wash it up, wash myself up, and then it's about to be bedtime, so I will try to put it back in.
What I then got to do was have a lot of conversations about, you know, what do we know about our vaginas?
I just discovered that Srishti doesn't know which hole we pee from.
Shook right now. Because I thought that with a cup inside, you would pee and then it'll be like a fountain. I've just been informed that there's another hole.
Oh, God. Srishti and all the ladies watching who are also shook, your homework is to go look at your vagina.
If the education minister is watching this, please can we have some sex education in schools?
Again, I've discovered something that Srishti didn't know that was really f***ing basic.
Did you know that she has to use this cup during this period and then reuse it in the next period?
Did you know that's the whole point, Srishti?
Just give me a penis.
It's not only with my colleagues and friends, but also with strangers on the internet.
So I just posted on Instagram that I'm using this menstrual cup for a video and also in life. And someone sent me a DM of a great point that I wanted to include. You know, to be able to use this product, you do need the privilege of a bathroom that affords you full privacy and clean water in that bathroom. And those are both privileges that a lot of women in India don't have.
My day generally starts with me going to the gym and then going to work. And by the end of the day, the pads would be quite full. But there was a slight logistical problem.
The problem is that I just went to pee and I needed to like change into another pad. But I just realized that I have only 3 pads and 2 of them are stupidly drying at home because they take so long to dry.
Of course, I can go ahead and buy more of those. Because I was going through such a bad experience, I just felt like not only do these cloth pads not want to be my friend, there weren't enough of them to support me in case I needed a friend. It wasn't a great time, guys.
Pads and tampons are designed to make it look like we bleed a lot, so we change them all the time, so we give our money. But as it turns out, we don't really bleed that much, and I'm so grateful to this cup for telling me that.
I honestly use the 3 cloth pads for 1 cycle. I guess they did do their job, like the blood wouldn't seep out through the cloth pad, but they moved around enough for my underwear to have blood on them. They did make me aware of the fact that I was on my period all the time. They were difficult to wash in terms of the stains didn't really come off that easily. They were difficult to dry. Just very difficult to deal with.
It's the cheapest because this cup cost me around 600 rupees for 1 cup. Whereas if you're using pads, you're spending 60 to 100 rupees every month. The cup can be used for 10 years. So it's the cheapest, it's the most comfortable, it's also good for the world, which doesn't hurt.
With your hormones already going crazy during your period, I don't think you need this added stress in your life that is just going to make you more angry and frustrated and feel like, I hate being on my period. I guess there's a reason why women moved on from using cloth as means of soaking up blood. So I definitely wouldn't recommend this to anybody.
I will use a menstrual cup for every single period I have between now and menopause. Not only that, I'm also telling everyone I know to use it.
go ahead and try something. If not cloth pads, definitely go ahead and try menstrual cups, try period panties. There are a lot more things out there that are being made. You might have a better experience than me. I really hope you have a better experience than me.
And having such an incredible experience made me realize that I've been deprived of all the information about my period. And so have, I think, most girls and women. So I feel a little cheated by society, which is a really standard feeling if you're a woman in the world, which is like, why am I getting such a bad deal? I think if we talked as a society, if we talked more honestly and freely and openly about women's bodies and about how to make women's experiences as convenient as possible, then I would have had a much easier last decade of perioding. Hey, periods aren't fun, but you know what is? BuzzFeed videos. Please subscribe to our channel so you can watch us do uncomfortable things with our bodies again. And please befriend your vagina.